guys, and welcome back to Real Life with Abby. My name is Abby Mbola. Thank you so much for stopping by. So if this is your first time on my channel, or you've been here before but have never subscribed, please consider subscribing by clicking on the red button and then click on the bell to turn on the notification so you can be notified whenever I post new videos. If you've already subscribed, thank you so much for coming back. It's really good to see you again. I appreciate you guys. I always appreciate you guys. Guys, a few days ago, I made a video on this Bayelsa State Deeper Life Bible Church couple, Bolingo Israel and Okokolom Jemima, who claimed their wedding was cancelled by the Bayelsa State overseer just because they ate together from the same plate a week before they were meant to get married. Apparently, the marriage was meant to have taken place on the 8th of June 2019, but according to them, during the traditional wedding on the 7th of June 2019, they received a text message from the marriage committee to say that their marriage scheduled for the next day had been suspended. It was alleged that the bride's parents went to see the pastor and knelt down to beg that the wedding be held, but that the pastor did not respond and walked out on them. The bride-to-be was also reported to have almost run mad after the incident, but for the grace of God. A lot of people came out and condemned the pastor and the marriage committee for this alleged act of wickedness. Some Deeper Life members stated that the general overseer of Deeper Life Bible Church, Pastor Kumuyi, has been complaining about the excesses of the marriage committee and has stated that he will disband them before he steps down as the general overseer. These comments from some church members made it easier for people to believe the allegation against the church by this so-called couple. So, a few days after that, Deeper Life Church has responded and spoken out regarding this allegation and have revealed exactly why the marriage was suspended. So I bring you the story captioned, Deeper Life Bible Church reacts to report of cancelling couple's wedding for eating from same plate. And the story goes, a Nigerian couple-to-be, Bolingo Israel and Okpokpolom Jemima, who are members of the Deeper Life Bible Church, had their wedding, which was slated to hold on June 8, 2019, suspended by their pastor. It was earlier reported that the wedding was allegedly suspended because the couple ate from the same plate a week before tying the knot. Well, the Deeper Life Church has reacted to the reports. In a statement, the church explained that contrary to reports, the couple had actually engaged in immoral acts after sleeping in the same bed, and it amounted to sin. The church further explained that after feeling guilty and reporting themselves to their respective pastors, the couple was placed on disciplinary action by the state overseer. So let's read the statement from the church, and it goes, the church has a marriage committee that supervises marriage right from knowing the will of God to obtaining parents' consent, marriage registration to church wedding. When the intended couples were told to go to Brass Region in Bayelsa State to obtain the man's parents' consent, they spent several days together before coming back to Yanagoa. They slept on the same bed and engaged in moral acts which amounted to sin and against the marriage process of the church. They felt what they had done was bad and reported themselves to their pastors. They were subsequently placed on discipline by the state overseer. After some period, reporting that they had repented, the courtship was allowed to commence again. As preparation for wedding was going on, it was discovered that they again engaged in acts contrary to the laid down procedure by the marriage committee of the church. This is after they had been disciplined earlier and warned not to engage in acts that will impact negatively on their proposed marriage. When the marriage committee put a direct question to them based on the latest development, the man accepted the error. It is important to note there that the church stands on holiness and members have been consistently admonished to abstain from all appearance of evil. It is not also true that the parents pleaded with the pastor to wed them on the 8th June 2019. The summary is that they behaved themselves unseemingly and were in haste to enjoy the benefits the church and God allow only married couples to enjoy. So guys, that was the Deeper Life Bible Church statement on this issue. So apparently the couple lied about their marriage being suspended because they ate from the same plate.
I'm sure they were not expecting the story to go viral, but you know, these days everything and anything is posted on social media. The story was sent to someone by their cousin. The guy that posted it on Twitter was bitter that this could have happened, so he decided to post the story asking Deeper Life to respond and explain, which Deeper Life have now done. Let's talk about the so-called couple. Only God knows who is serving him, really. They went against the doctrine of the church regarding marriage. They opened their mouths to confess to their pastor. They then continued in the act despite being cautioned. One thing is this: you cannot serve God and serve mammon at the same time. You are either a real born again Christian or you are wasting your time pretending to be one. There is no two ways about it. Everyone is a sinner, but don't pretend to be a saint. Everyone knows the doctrine in Deeper Life Church is strictly Bible based and you are not allowed to cut corners. Although people do it forgetting that even when the pastor or other church members cannot see them, the all-knowing God does. My thinking is that when the couple knew they were not able to abide by the doctrines laid down by Deeper Life Bible Church, why did they not leave Deeper Life and go to all these other boju-boju Pentecostal churches where anything goes? No one cares about what the Bible actually says in some of these Pentecostal churches. The pastor openly commits all atrocities and church members follow suit. Let's take a look at this recent Koza Church and Pastor Fatoyinbo's recent controversy on morality and infidelity, where the women were being used by the pastor and they failed to speak out for so long. It was even alleged that Pastor Fatoyinbo's wife knew all that was going on, and instead of praying for her husband to be delivered and telling her husband to repent from the evil, she placed all the blame on the female congregant. Yes, a pastor is a human being, but the Holy Spirit is there to support in times of temptation. That is if you are truthful to yourself that you have a problem and ask God to take away whatever thorn is in your flesh. But for as long as one continues to pretend that all is well, when there is a serious problem, the devil will continue to punish you. So that's what is going on in the cases of these pastors that pretend nothing is wrong with them. We are all human. Everyone can be tempted. We all need to ask God to help us, the Holy Spirit to help us. But when we pretend that we are fine, that we cannot fall, that is when we fall. We are all human beings and we are all exposed to temptations. If you look at the Bible, there is no single one in the Bible that never had a problem. Everyone, every man in the Bible that were actually described as men after the heart of God, men of faith, they all had problems at one point or the other. It was only Jesus Christ in the Bible that never fail. Abraham did, he lied. Isaac did, he lied. David, King David did, he lied. He committed adultery, but each time they did what they did, they knew when to come back to God to ask for forgiveness. But nowadays, even when the pastors know they've done something wrong, instead of holding their hands up and saying, God, have mercy on me, they pretend that nothing has happened. It doesn't work that way. We are all human beings. None of us is immune to temptation. It is only by the grace of God that we stand. So this Deeper Life couple, when they knew they did not have the grace to abstain and knew they had derailed after their first suspension, why did they not just go to the registry and get married rather than want to play on the church's intelligence, believing they would get away with breaking the rules? They wanted to eat their cake and at the same time have it. I don't believe the church could have made up their own part of the story. What they have said is likely to be the whole truth. So let's take a look at a few comments on the church's statement. Trust Nigerians, they will always come out to make their own comment. So Shalandada quoted Colossians 2:20-23, and he wrote, since you died with Christ to the elemental spiritual forces of this world, why, as though you still belong to the world, do you submit to its rules? Do not handle, do not taste, do not touch. These rules, which have to do with things that are all destined to perish with use, are based on merely human commands and teachings. Such regulations indeed have an appearance of wisdom with their self-imposed worship, their false humility, and their harsh treatment of the body, but they lack any value in restraining sensual indulgence. So Priscilla Ibiye Amakri, just ignore him. He is ignorant of who Jesus is. Focus on the finished work of Christ on the cross. Is Jesus judgmental? No. That is enough for us. He came to save, and we believe and have accepted Jesus. Enjoy it. Leave the misleading of these people. Pray for those who don't know that their hearts shall be touched by God Himself. If they've confused people enough, don't let them bother you. No one can determine your destiny but Jesus. I'm not really sure what this person is trying to say. Are you saying the church is judgmental? I don't know about that. So Soji Ogunaike said, you all know that before marriage was instituted, siblings were mating and giving birth, right? How can you allow your fellow man to tell you how best to live your life just because they claim to have a more special connection with God? Guys, come on. Religion was and is the most effective form of human control. Let's hope we can emancipate ourselves. MacBriel Norrit. The question is, when are couples considered married? Is it when they have paid bride price and the woman given to the man by her family and father? Or is it when they wear gown and suit and stand on the altar and take the oath? Biblically, who gives the woman in marriage to the man? Like some people asked, did the apostles and Jesus collect tithe? Did the apostles and Jesus wed couples? Or were they marrying traditionally? Bible scholars, come on, let's trash it, laugh out loud. If it's fornication or adultery, when after a man does a traditional wedding, then sleeps with his wife, what happens to those couples who started living together because the woman got pregnant? Some of them have not even paid the bride price. They got born again and are recognized as married couple without proper investigation to know if they had a white wedding. Why are they allowed to continue committing the fornication since without white wedding, it's fornication? Something needs to be corrected here. So that was MacBriel Norrit's comment. So Lushala Cole replied, Dada, most response to this post missed the point. Firstly, sin is sin, no matter how we look at it. Secondly, that is the church, deeper life doctrine, which they subjected themselves to. Thirdly, is it biblical for them to be sanctioned? This is open to biblical debate. As regards the father, the said doctrine is man-made. Even Christ obeyed worldly rule as related to payment of tax. The Bible also admonishes us to obey government rules. So basically, the doctrine is for the church, which is in tandem with the scriptures. So guys, there are so many comments on this church's statement, but that's a few that I've read to you. And you can see people responded in different ways. Some agree with the church, some don't. But personally, I would say you are either in or out. The Bible is explicit, but we humans are our own problems. I will not say that the church is wrong to have cancelled the wedding. Where there are rules, there are repercussions. So the couple broke the rules of the church and got the punishment as laid down by the church. We cannot deliberately set out to commit sin if we say we are born again Christians. The Bible says in Romans 6:1-2, what shall we say then? Shall we continue in sin that grace may abound? God forbid. How shall we that are dead to sin live any longer therein? We all sin in different ways, and a sin is a sin. But who is innocent? Let him cast the first stone. That's what I will say personally. Like I said, I'm not going to condemn what the church has done. And I'm not saying what they've done is right. But if you're going to a church, you know what the rules are. You know what the doctrine is. You need to abide by the doctrines of that church. They've laid down the rules, and they know there are repercussions if you break those rules. So if you break the rules, you should expect the repercussions. You should expect to be punished. So if you cannot abide by the rules of the church, then go to a church where there are no rules and you can do whatever you like. That's what I can say. If they cannot abide by the rules of the church, of Deeper Life Church, they can move to another church where nobody is going to tell them what to do and they can get away with anything. That's my own thinking, really. Like I said, I'm not condemning what the church has done, and I'm not saying what they've done is right, but there are rules to be kept. Rules are there to be obeyed. If you disobey a rule, you get punished for disobeying the rule. That's it, basically. That's the way it works. So guys, that's the update on the marriage that was suspended by Deeper Life Bible Church in Bayelsa. It was not because they shared a meal, but because they shared a bed before marriage. The couple has not come out to dispute what the church has written, but I'm taking it that their silence means the church has spoken the truth. So guys, comment in the comment section, please. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and I shall see you in the next video. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.